So it was into the Bolga township. I mean, from the hotel last night when the team dropped, we decided to pass through the town for the people to know we are in. Shatta just wanted to warm himself up into the space. So yes, of course, the team had to go, but these are just some few footages from me when I went to the place where the setup and everything was ongoing and stuff. And in fact, you can clearly see the enthusiasm by which these fans are so much hyper for the event tonight. It's crazy, it's crazy. All these footages are footages from the afternoon sessions where fans were getting ready, getting their paraphernalia from flags to t-shirts to banners to stickers to whatever, and it was crazy, it was crazy. Then yes, these are just some sights and scenes of people who just wanted to chill, wanted to get, yes, you know, the SM family is one big family, and this is all in the town of Borga, where the people were doing wonders, where the people were doing wonders. The happiness was crazy. They couldn't wait to see the king the early hours of the day. And we went into the place proper, proper, a very vast land called the Bolga Sports Stadium, the iconic Bolga Sports Stadium, where most of the top matches used to happen. But now it looks like, yes, it wasn't going on. But these guys did something beautiful, of which I wanted to show you guys. I mean, they created a place just different from the show. This has nothing to do with the organizers, because according to them, this is where they are also creating as a parking space for their motorbikes, where you come and you're able to park your bike, and after the show, you go. So these are the guys that were able to make that beautiful initiative, and it had nothing to do with the organizers. These are people in the town who are also doing everything in their power to make sure this particular show goes on and goes on very well. In fact, you can clearly see that the stickers and banners all scattered around the place, and everything is what you can just do nothing but admire. In fact, when we were doing the rounds in the town, when Shatta said he wanted to go through the town, these are the guys that some of the guys that were with us throughout the period. That is manager Sammy Flex, also, yes, collecting his samba over there, just enjoying the whole frenzy and everything. And it was crazy, it was crazy. I mean, from Shatta himself to the last person in the team, anybody that meets a fan or whatever, it's crazy. And this was when Shatta was leaving his hotel into his car through to the street, and getting out of the hotel itself was a huge challenge for us, as the fans did not even want like the whole arrangement was serious. The whole arrangement was serious. Sometimes you think about SM fans and you wonder, so which part from north to south, east and west, like, are they gentle? Like, which part? And you tend to ask yourself, like, where Shatta comes and the whole place goes haywire. Sometimes you see them, everybody is calm, everybody is gentle, until the person that they call him the street president, the street king, the street lord, steps into the scene, and the whole place catch fire to the extent that Charlie, everybody wants to catch a glimpse of the man. Everybody wants to catch a glimpse of the champion, of the people's person. And the whole street of Borga was one that was a spectacle this afternoon. Sometimes you go through some of these townships and you may think that, oh, maybe his fans is limited to a certain section, but I mean, you can clearly see the enthusiasm at which people were really jacked up just to receive the king you can clearly see some of these. The reception was crazy. The reception was crazy. Where fans all in the quest to make merry and to catch a glimpse of Shatta, all were in possession, like were in just to see the king, from student to adult to kids to even grown-ups. And sometimes you ask, so at which section doesn't Shatta's fans cut across? And some conversations, when you listen to some conversation, this is the same person that some people think, oh, he's lost his relevance and he's done this, he's done that, and he's done this, he's done that. I mean, yes, he has his flaws, but when you look at how people love him, when you look at how people cherish him and they would want to do everything in their power to make sure the king is happy one way or the other, you tend to ask yourself, so what is giving people the doubt that this man is one of the most relevant artists in the world after 2 serious decades? Like, how many artists still holds this number of street cred when they go out after 2 decades? It's not easy. Let's check some of his colleagues that he came with into the industry and how they are faring now and how they are faring now. So yeah, that is the street king on the streets of Bolga. This was when he called a certain woman who could not be with a youth in a rush to dash her bundles of money. And you can clearly see the kind of reception when everybody in their little corner would want to catch a glimpse at their king. But I mean, I had some one-on-one session with Shatta where there were certain things that he addressed. Like, he spoke about the reception that he had, the reception that he had on the streets and how he felt and everything. I mean, this is crazy. This is crazy. If we can have over 10 different artists in this country who are going to have this kind of reception whenever they go out, it's super nice. It's super nice. It's super nice. Where, Charlie, it adds to their relevance. And like I said, from students to teachers to adults to whoever, everybody rushing just to get a glimpse of the king when he comes back. No wonder in recent times there have been calls of Shatta for president. Shatta for president. What? Where is this conversation coming from, of where Shatta is being tipped to be going for the presidency and all that? Like, where is this particular conversation coming from? Where is this particular conversation coming from? But then all these things are evidences. All these things are signs and stuff to show that, yes, when it comes to street cred, when it comes to on-ground love, Shatta has it. In fact, on the streets of Bolga, the Upper East region, you can clearly see the reception of which he got. The reception of which he got in the space. In the space, like I said, I had some one-on-one with him where he touched on everything that he felt, everything or how he felt about the reception. For the cash, there it went from 5 CD to 10 CD to 20 CDs. I mean, they were just flying, they were just flying, going, flying, going, flying, going, flying, going, like that. And these are top musicians, like top musicians. It is only top musicians who can do some of these gestures. Yes, when it comes to giving back to society, Shatta Wale as one artist is one that you can't take that away from him. You can't take that away from him. Where he's one artist that you can't take that away from him. So yeah. enjoy some of these things. Enjoy, 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 enjoy. When I come back, I'll come and tell you how Shatta was able to maneuver his way through the big crowd, how he felt. And I asked him, Shatta for president, what he thinks about it and how he even intends to do so, and how he personally sees the calling in terms of him being president of Ghana. You think he stands the chance? Are people going to vote for him as the president of Ghana? And would you even advise he joins any political party as far as this particular move is concerned? Whatever it is, yes, this is Shatta Wale, the musician. He has Shatta Wale as a businessman, as well as Shatta as the one that everybody loves. So yeah, let me just play you the tape. Let me just play you the tape of him. Let me just play you the tape of him doing wonders and all how he felt with regards to even Shatta for president. Listen to this one.
Be with them. So I think this shows how, you know, impactful we are in our society and how we really want to support the society and let them know that Shatta Wale is for them. And no matter what, we don't forget who made us, you know, who we are today in terms of the Shatta Wale brand, that Shatta knows them and we really want to be with them. And this is a beautiful occasion for us to celebrate with them. So I think these are beautiful people that have made us know that this is the man we want and this is the guy we want. It's a blessing. Thank you to Bolga.
Speaking of the man we want, There's one statement now I'm seeing on social media, Shatta for president. Where is this dream coming from, especially now?
Well, I think it's the people, the fans, you know, like we're just in our convoy right now, and, you know, you could hear some of the backers, you know, saying, Shatta, we want you for president, we want you for president. I think I'm going into a man now that we should start, you know, thinking about that, because like they say, the voice of the people is the voice of God. You know, and Ghanaians have been through hardship, they've been through struggles, they've been through stuff. And if we believe that we can help, why not? Because Shatta has already been helping them in terms of, you know, taking care of school kids, you know, paying hospital bills and, you know, watching a lot of people. And it's been grateful. So if the fans are saying and the people are saying, it's the people, the fans are the people. And you can see the numbers that are out there screaming. We've never had this. Not only in Bolga, but almost all the regions in Ghana have really said this to us. And if we've come to the upper side or the, you know, the northern side of Ghana, and we can still hear this, and I believe we can, you know, satisfy the people by doing what they want.
Thank you, boss. Thank you. Thank you.